بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه أما بعد. This is our sixth lesson going through the poem تحفة الأطفال والغلمان في تجويد القرآن authored by الشيخ سليمان الجمزوري رحمه الله تعالى. We stopped at the statement of the author رحمه الله at line number 24 حكم لام ال ولام الفعل. He says عليه رحمة الله للام الحالان قبل الحروف أولاهما إظهارها في التعريف قبل أرباع مع عشرة خذ علمه من ابغ حجك وخف عقيمه ثانيهما إدغامها في أربع وعشرة أيضا ورمزها فعي طب ثم صل رحما تفز ضف ذا نعم دع سوء ظن زر شريفا للكرم واللام الأولى سمها قمرية واللام الأخرى سمها شمسية وأظهرن لام فعل مطلقة في نحو قل نعم وقلنا والتقى. So the author in this chapter he speaks about two forms of the lam. The lam of al which is known as lam al-ta'rif and it is also known in English language as the definite lam. As the definite lam. The definite lam al is a lam sakinah and it generally precedes indefinite nouns, which we call in the Arabic language nakirat, and it makes them into a ma'rifa. It makes them into definite nouns. For example, rajul means a man. I want to put an al in front of it, it becomes the man, al-rajul, right? And so this lam sakina, it can occur in that format. This lam sakina can occur as a definite lam. And so there are two rules that can be extracted from this phenomenon of a lam sakina being followed by one of the Arabic letters. And we can divide them into two sets of 14. Two sets of 14, there are 28 letters, 28 divided by 2 is 14. If 14 Arabic letters come after this lam with ta'rif, then what occurs is al-idhar. And we call this lam, lam qamariyah. And if the other set of 14 letters come after this lam with ta'rif, then what happens is a complete merging, a complete idhar. And we call it lam shamsiyah. And the reason why we call lam qamariyah lam shamsiyah is because these two examples, the sun and the moon, they show the ruling. So when I say qamar, I mean by it a moon. But when I say al qamar, you can see clearly I put an al in front of it, it becomes the moon, and the lam is crystal clear. It's clear, it's apparent, you can hear it. Al qamar, right? There's no merging. Shams means the sun, right? If I put an al in front of it, it becomes ash shams. As you can see here, where's the lam gone? The lam has been completely merged into the sheen. And so it's become ash-shams. Al-qamar ash-shams. You see, it shows these two examples show the ruling. It shows the ruling of this lam al-ta'rif. That if certain letters come before come after it, what happens is complete merging. And if certain letters comes after it, what happens is no merging at all, which is al-idhar. Let's look at some examples. When it comes to the idhar, the author, he mentioned that you can group these letters into the acronym إِبْغِ حَجَّكَ وَخَفْ عَقِيمَهُ إِبْغِ حَجَّكَ وَخَفْ عَقِيمَهُ. The first letter is the Hamza, الأر. The second letter is the Ba, البقرة. The third letter is the غين, الغمام. The fourth letter is the ح, الحمير. The fifth letter is the جيم, الجنة. The sixth letter is الكتاب, the كاف. The next letter is the واو, الوسيلة. The next letter is the خاء, الخلد, الخروف. The فاء is after that, which is الفرقان. The عين is العظيم. طيب. The قاف. The قاف is what we mentioned, القمر. The ياء, اليوم. The ميم, الموت. The هاء, الهدهد. You see these 14 letters made up by the phrase إِبْغِ حَجَّكَ وَخَفْ عَقِيمَهُ. If these letters come after the لام التعريف, then you know straight away the لام التعريف will be recited with الإظهار. However, if the other set of 14 letters come after the لام التعريف, then what happens is that the لام التعريف must be recited with complete merging along with the letter that comes after it, such that they become one حرف حرفا واحدا مشددا, one emphasized letter carrying the حركة of the letter that comes second. So, for example, the ta, or the classic example we gave, the sheen, ash-shams, the lam has been completely merged into the sheen. طيب, and it has the haraka of the sheen, which is fatha. The acronym that is given for you to memorize these 14 letters is given by the author rahimahullah as the first letters of the line number 28, I believe, or line number 27, where he says, طيب ثم صل رحمن تفوز ضفذان عن دع سوء ظن زر شريفا للكرم. So the ta from طيب, for example, والطور, right? طيب ثم, the tha from ثم, الثمرة, right? طيب ثم صل صاد الصالحات, طيب ثم صل رحمن راء الرحمن, the ta, طيب ثم صل رحمن تفوز, the ta, التقوى, تفوز ضف, the ضاد, الضحى, ذي ذال, طيب ثم صل رحمن تفوز ضف ذا نعم الذاكرين, and then نعم النبي, دع, which is the الدنيا, the scene, دع سوء, which is الساعة, دع سوء ظن ضاء, which is مثلا الظالمين, زر is the زاي, example for that, الزبر, الزبور, right? The next letter, شين, دع سوء ظن زر شريفا, is الشمس, which we gave earlier on. And then we have the last one, دع سوء ظن زر شريفا للكرم, the lam here in للكرم, والليل, الليل. So these letters, if they come after the lam والتعريف, then the lam والتعريف is merged completely with the letter that comes after it, بحيث يصيران حرفا واحدا مشددا, بحيث يصيران حرفا واحدا مشددا. Then the author in line number 29 speaks about lam الفعل. He says, وأظهرن لام فعل مطلقة في نحو قل نعم وقلنا والتقى. He's talking about the lam that can take place or that can occur in the verbs. And there are three types of verbs: past tense verb, present tense verb, and command verb. فعل ماضي, فعل مضارع, فعل أمر. And so he gives examples of the فعل ماضي and the فعل أمر in the line of poetry. وأظهرن لام فعل مطلقة في نحو قل نعم وقلنا والتقى. So قل نعم, the قاف here, or the lam here in قل, it means it's a command verb to say. قل نعم, say yes, right? And so this lam has to be made what? مظهر. It has to be made with إظهار. Because and the reason why he's highlighting this is because some people might do idgham. So they might say قل نعم وهذا خطأ. That's a mistake. Or they might say قلنا وهذا خطأ. You can't do idgham here because this is not a lam وتعريف. This is lam فعلين. This is a lam, a verbal lam. And so you say قل نعم وأنتم داخلون. And the reason why idgham can take place is because the lam and the noon are very close to each other in makhraj. The lam and the noon are very close to each other in makhraj. And so the beginning student might find it difficult to transfer from the makhraj of the lam after he did idhar to the makhraj of the noon. And so what happens is a khalal takes place, a deficiency takes place, where he, instead of making idhar of both of these letters, he does what? Idgham. And that's a mistake. So he says, قلنا. You don't say قلنا يا ذا القرنين. Okay, you say قلنا يا ذا القرنين. You say التقى. You don't say اتقى. طيب. Likewise, you say قل نعم يلتقياني. طيب. You don't say يتقياني. طيب. You say يلتقياني. Make the lam clear. Make the ta clear. Make the lam clear. Make the noun clear. I.e. make the letter of the lam, the verbal lam clear, and whatever comes after it also clear. And what I mean by clear is, of course, pronouncing each of these letters from their articulation point, making it clear and apparent. والله تعالى أعلم. We'll stop here بإذن الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. استغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.